Personally and professionally, Gordie Howe was on top of his game as he reigned as league scoring champion for four consecutive seasons.
Gordie almost looked like maybe he might be falling asleep out on the ice. That's how relaxed he was, you know. And he had a great gift that he could, if there was a stoppage of play, he could kneel down on the ice and recover very quickly. You know, he had that gift.
He could be on the ice so long. The stamina, the strength, his natural ability, to me, made him the player that he was. And I've always had, too, the feeling that he enjoyed playing the game so much. So if you put all those great ingredients together, that's what makes a superstar like he is. He's in a class by himself.
He was the one guy without a weakness. He had wonderful shots, front hand, back hand. He was ambidextrous, so he could shoot from both sides. He was big, he was tough. He was a wonderful skater. He had maximum anticipation. Gordie, in his whole career, never wasted a step. He could figure out where the puck was going, and he'd go there in the shortest distance. He was a great defensive player who knew how to play in his own end, and he was as tough as any man who ever played.
He could kill penalty, pay the plow play, regular shift. He used to carry the puck smooth. You know, very dangerous. He could shoot the puck. Strong player. He was a very, very, very strong player's guardian.
He could do everything on the ice, and he was so big and strong that you feared him when he was out there. And he could put the puck in the net, he could make the plays. He was the all-round ultimate hockey player at that time.
In the 1950s, four Stanley Cup championships and six consecutive first place finishes made Gordie Howe and the Detroit Red Wings the top team in the game. For Gordie, the Stanley Cup meant everything.
And the only thing of sadness too is, hey, I have to do it all over again next year. It's not like something you can keep forever. You have to earn it every year you play. So it's when we won it 4 or 6 years, that was the core of a great hockey club.
Well, I'd been there probably 7 or 8 years before I got a chance to be on the same line with Gordie and Ted Lindsay. And I remember the guys on the bench, Bob Goldham and a few of them, say, look, give the big guy the puck and they'll deliver the mail, as they used to say. So I never forgot that.